Respiratory care is a relatively new discipline in the medical field. However, its practices date back throughout the history of civilization. Respiratory therapists treat patients with acute and chronic conditions of the heart and lungs. The job title hasn't been around very long. However, the fundamental practices of respiratory care have been used throughout the 20th century. In this video, we're going to mention a few of the significant events that occurred in respiratory care throughout history. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, here are some of the major historical events that occurred in respiratory care throughout history. All the way back in 1909, oral intubation was introduced, but it wasn't until 1913 that the laryngoscope was developed to assist with intubation. In 1918, oxygen masks were used to treat pulmonary edema. In 1928, the iron lung was developed, which is a negative pressure ventilator that was useful in treating patients during the polio epidemic. In 1947, the Inhalation Therapy Association, or ITA, was formed, which was the major association for respiratory therapists at the time. In 1948, the first positive pressure ventilator was introduced. In 1954, the ITA becomes the American Association for Inhalation Therapists, or AAIT. In 1958, the Bird Mark VII was introduced, which is the classic IPPB device that was originally used to provide short-term or intermittent positive pressure ventilation. In 1967, rapid blood gas analysis was introduced, thanks to the PH Clark Servinghouse electrode. In 1968, the Fiberoptic bronchoscope was introduced for clinical use. In 1971, CPAP was introduced for the first time, and the Respiratory Care Journal was introduced in 1971 as well. In 1973, the AAIT becomes the American Association for Respiratory Therapists, or AART. In 1974, the National Board for Respiratory Therapy, or NBRT, was founded. And in 1983, the NBRT becomes the National Board for Respiratory Care, or NBRC, which is the organization that is responsible for awarding and maintaining credentialing for respiratory therapists in the United States. In 1983, Respiratory Care Week was nationally proclaimed by President Ronald Reagan. In 1984, the AART becomes the American Association for Respiratory Care, or AARC, which is now the primary organization that supports respiratory therapists in the United States. In 1994, the CDC published guidelines for the prevention of ventilator-associated pneumonia. And in 1998, the COARC, or Committee on Accreditation for Respiratory Care, was formed to provide accreditation for respiratory therapy schools and programs in the United States. Again, these are just a few events that I wanted to bring to your attention that I thought were interesting and useful when it comes to the history of respiratory care. I do want to point out that this information and the dates were obtained from the Egan's Fundamental of Respiratory Care textbook. It's a book that we recommend for all respiratory therapists and students because it covers the entire field of respiratory care from top to bottom. If you want to learn more, I'll drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.